God is transferred by way of the Spirit of God to the Spirit of Akeisha and to you, to your spirit. Lord, help us.
Amen.
We're so happy today. But I'm going to hear good preaching. Besides my preachers, I call a good friend.
Amen.
Hey, help us, Lord. That's Elder Mitchell.
Amen.
And Evelyn, so happy to have you with us.
Amen.
I did say, and pray, by the way, bring your wife. Help us, Lord. I said that.
Amen.
I'm happy I did do it, too.
Amen.
You know, he needed to change his clothes and sometimes
the cap.
He talked that talk, but I know. Help us, Lord. After the selection for solo, my good friend, Pastor and the priest, we know this Peaceful Baptist Church.
Oh,
Did
Mm. And I was like, do it? And the best he wants from you is just you want to stand on the gate, you want to run the race, you want to do all that stuff. And when you cry, like, lead to me, just run me back down.
Lord Jesus.
Do it because you love it.
That's right.
Don't come here because, you know, mama brought you and you're trying to keep the jinx off you. Only people who understand what I'm talking about is from the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Do it because you love him.
Yes.
Because he surely loves you.
Yes, he does.
Surely loves you. No doubt about it. This morning, I'd like to bring your attention to Philippians chapter 4. Philippians chapter 4, looking at the fourth verse. Philippians once again, everybody was turning page, so to get there. Philippians 4 and 4.
Yes, sir.
We'll have our reading. Amen.
Amen.
And the scripture says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, you may be seated.
Amen.
You may be seated. Philippians is written by the Apostle Paul.
Yeah.
It's known as one of his prison letters. It's along with Ephesians, Colossians, and Philemon. Let me parenthetically stop for a second and say, if you want to know about your salvation and you want to get saved and know you're saved, it's important that you check out the epistles of Paul.
Mm-hmm.
No. I want you to really consider reading the epistles of Paul.
Mm-hmm.
And that starts all the way back with Romans to find you. Because that's where you find salvation.
Mm-hmm.
You may not think about this, or maybe never thought about it, but there's no salvation in the Gospels of the Kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
The Gospels of the Kingdom are truly written for the Jewish people.
Amen.
And what God has done, has given this little man, the Apostle Paul, who once named was Saul, who raised all the hell that he raised in Jerusalem, he gave him a commission after saving him to be the apostles to
Gentiles. Amen.
We're going to read something that the Lord has given to somebody for you.
Amen.
At least you ought to agree.
Amen.
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 In this fourth chapter here, this part we'll be dealing with just this morning, I told you long. But as he says, rejoice in the Lord, and again I say rejoice, he goes on to deal with the fifth verse, where he says, let your moderation be known unto all men, that the Lord is at peace. You're having problems in your life like we all do. And there's a prayer that we need to lock into and hold on to. Go right here. This is a help for all of us. Whatever you're dealing with, it doesn't make a difference. Family, friends, sickness, whatever. Let's talk to the Lord about it.
Oh, yeah.
Let me say, the Lord is at hand. You need to have rejoicing whatever you're going through. Why? You being a believer, the Lord is at hand.
Amen.
As believers, we may feel alone, but we've never known.
That's right. Said,
that's right.
He said, I will never leave you. That's what he said.
Yes.
And our Lord is no shorter than his word. And when he talks about this gentleness of verse 5 there, he's talking about being content.
Mm-hmm.
To be what? Have a generosity in your spirit.
Yeah.
And towards others.
Yeah.
See, if you have a generosity towards others, even though you're going through something, you know, you don't push that on somebody else. don't call me at 4 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the morning. And tell them that somebody's sick in the hospital or didn't make it. They'll still be where we at by 7:30.
Amen.
Woo, Lord.
Are we together, everybody?
Yeah.
So far, so good. It's only five verses, and we've done knocked out two of them already. Come on, bless the Lord. Before you even realize I was here, I'll be gone. And in verse 6, just to mention, he said, be careful for how many things?
Nothing.
For nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And you're careful for what?
Everything.
Oh, you're going to be president. You're going to be father. I'm going to cut my check. Come on. Am I truly saved? My name on the book or is it written? It says, be careful for nothing. But in everything, do what?
Prayer.
First of all, you can take it what? To the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
That's the key right there. Whatever going on that you need to, that's why I say this is a prayer. A good way of locking into whatever's going on in your
life.
First, it says start talking to the Lord.
Yeah.
And the only way we need to learn how to talk to the Lord about getting away from folk.
Yeah.
You know, you got to get away from folk. I mean, if you can't get away, wait, go to the bathroom, but get away. No, you need some pride. You don't need to be expressing nothing. Because everybody you're talking to is going to help their own self. They got troubles themselves. So what? We talk to the Lord about it.
Amen.
Not only that, but he says, look, in all of the supplication and what? Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
I thought I heard this morning somebody praying and saying that we have to learn how to say thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you,
Lord.
Not that it happened and you cure the situation right there, fix something, but you know that you're told it to somebody who's able to do it and are willing to look at his will, his way, and his time.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Talk to him.
Yeah.
Talk to him.
Yeah.
He said Thanksgiving.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you know it or not, but if you really talk to Lord, get it out of spread. You might have went to him crying and feeling misprayed. Yeah, but Lord, if you can talk to Lord about something, oh, when you thank the God that you can.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
It goes on to a statement, let what? Let your requests
be known.
Be known to God. Tell him what's going on.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Somebody said, no, he already knows everything, but what? That ain't got nothing to do with it.
That's right.
Talking to him about what I'm going through helps. It doesn't help him, it helps me.
That's right.
You got that? It helps me.
Yes, Lord.
I'm not as angry as I was. I'm not as hurting as I was. I wasn't upset as I was. Yes. I'm giving to the Lord.
Yes.
And he's already working on me because I brought it.
Amen.
Amen.
What else he says in this 7th verse? He goes on to tell us that we don't need to what? Be anxious, right?
Mm-mm.
Saying don't worry about stuff that we bring it to the Lord. Worrying and frustrated about things shows how much we trust the Lord. Or in this case, how much less we trust the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Because let them know that he's able.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Don't scream out the church how able he is. Oh, praise the Lord. And then on the other hand, you say you have faith in the Lord?
Mm-hmm.
Then I want to let you know that your faith will be tested.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I've been to church and I give tithes and offerings, and I love my pastor, and I love my brothers and sisters, but Brother Daddy won't cut it.
Amen.
You're going to be tested.
Oh, yeah, God.
And that's going to be nice because it's going to come from somebody you never thought it would come from.
Mm-hmm.
And then you want to know what's happened, Lord. I've done for this because it's not what you do for the Lord.
That's right.
If you didn't do it with the motivation or with the fact of love for him, regardless of what comes down the pipe, and you didn't do it with the right spirit.
Yeah.
And the Lord deals with us according to how we have him.
Mm-hmm.
If I do something for him, then he has to do something for me. Does not work, but
Yeah, that's right.
He goes on in that same vein here and tells us that in God's wisdom, and we have to realize that he is sovereign and he's the one who has the power.
That's right.
Just stick with it. Don't know something and don't, you know what a light switch happens, you're out there walking around in the dark. We do things. If you know that, you know the word. You know you're saved.
Yeah.
But you keep acting like you're not.
Mm-hmm.
You keep talking about why I keep thinking of them thoughts I think, and why, if I'm saved. Why 2:00 in the morning I'm thinking about this foolish?
My Lord.
The truth of the matter is, you still in the flesh, knucklehead. Mm-hmm. And this flesh still want to act up.
Amen. Oh, yeah.
I'm the only one waiting on that night. You got to understand, as long as you're in the flesh,
that's right.
You're going to have thoughts. You're gonna
that's
have,
right.
But the whole matter is, even when you act up, and we do, we have someone between God and man.
Yes.
A mediator.
Yes.
We have a lawyer.
Yes.
We have somebody to step up for us.
Amen.
Oh, yes. To tell the Father, I pay for that one too.
Uh-huh.
You know, to live in the wilds and stay out in the dust like a pig in the mud, knowing that you are a child of God, and since you are a child of God, God has an obligation to take care of you.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
If you think right, so this is his prayer about, if you think right, then you do right.
Yes.
But I dare you to think wrong and do right. And it's not going to happen. Let me determine what you do.
That is true.
It is true.
Yes, sir.
Whatever you believe, you don't believe, you don't get, you believe, then you're going to act accordingly.
That's your will.
Brother, what Paul is saying is, it's the mind. And not only that, brothers and sisters, he said that man cannot comprehend. You cannot comprehend God's will dealing with stuff.
That's right.
You ain't going to deal with it. For he told us, he says in the Old Testament, Ephesians and Isaiah, he said, my ways are not your ways.
That's right.
And my thoughts.
Not your thoughts.
That's there it is. What he would do, he would do.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to understand that. Win, lose, or draw. Now we come to the close of this thing and this message. He says, finally, then it's all over. It doesn't finally. Your prayer coming to me now. He said, finally, my brothers.
Uh-huh.
Whatsoever things are true. So we have to ask the question, what things are true? The word of God is true.
Yeah. Yeah.
So when you're going through something, where should you go?
To the word of God.
Not to this field. This is a prayer. And in this prayer, we come that's not pleasing to him.
Yes, sir.
If he loves him, yeah. Love has nothing to do with hugging and kissing. You do know this, right? Anybody who had a grandmother, a loving mother, or even a good father, no, when they was bust you behind, that wasn't good. They could just do it. It's because you did something that you didn't, correct?
Amen.
And that's a love move.
Amen.
Now we don't want to touch him, we don't want to have nothing to say. And then we go, I can't do nothing with him. Oh, he's got to shoot him. Now he's going to want to shoot him.
Mm-hmm.
So, as I go to my seat, I'm just saying to you, go to when you go to sleep, go home this afternoon. Check it out.
Mm-hmm.
See what it says. See how Paul is coming to this point. If you get opportunity to read those four, it's done four chapters. See how he breaks it down before you get to this fact called love.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Because it's this Jesus who went, as we know, who went to the cross.
Mm-hmm.
With that little word, I've been telling you folks, and I've learned from my pastor. The Greek word is hubris.
Mm-hmm.
And hubris means whatever God has done, is done for you.
Oh, yes.
He died for you.
Thank you, Lord.
He was buried for you.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And he rose.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
One day. For you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. He's coming back. Amen. 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 Amen.
Peaceful Baptist Church. Peaceful Baptist Church.
That's it.
Arthur Mitchell.
Amen.
Great job, great preaching. Part of your sin, Christ died for you. And you're here this morning, it takes the power of the living God to move you from where you are to where you should be. Confess it with your mouth, believe with your heart that God has raised him from the dead, and God will give unto you eternal life. It's a God thing. Dead men cannot rise from where they are. It takes the power of the living God, the Holy Spirit, to apply what Christ did on the cross to your life.
Amen.
He quickens your spirit.
Yes.
Makes
yes.
you alive.
Thank
Lord.
You. Thank you.
It takes God to do it because he wants all the glory.
Oh, yeah.
He saves us.
Yes,
we are bought with a price, and now our own. Help us, Lord. We are saved by grace through faith.
Yes.
It's a gift of God.
Yes.
God gives it to us.
Oh,
and
yeah.
we can't lose it. Once we've been born, we can't be unborn.
Amen.
Oh, the Lord has some knucklehead children. He knew how to handle them.
Yes.
But once we've been saved, we're saved. Are you here today?
Yes, Lord.
Or maybe someone looking for a church home. And God said, the Holy Spirit said, this is the place I want to place you.
Yes.
Don't come unless God says so.
That's right.
Help us, Lord. That's it. Are you here today? And when you come,
amen.
Help us, Lord.
Amen.
Doors of the church open. It is not an invitation. The message is not an invitation, it's a proclamation.
Uh-huh.
That God brags about his son. That he was born and being found in the form of God, but thought it got wrong with it. Oh, help us, Lord.
Oh, yeah.
He brags about what Jesus did.
Yeah.
Oh, bless his name. Are you here today? And will you come? Will you come? You must be born again.
Amen.
Not a religious experience, but a God experience. The only way you're going to see God is by way of faith in Jesus Christ. Are you here today?
Amen.
Will you come?
Amen.
God bless you today.
Amen.
God bless you. I was offered And then yours to refuse. You may be seated.
Amen.
Amen.